That's right. It would have to be C. If alpha is 360 degrees, that means we're looking at the entire circumference. This D would be identical to C. Now, we're starting to see an equation emerge. This circumference somehow depends on this distance and this angle, alpha. Now, I guess we'll have to add the distance to our wish list because we don't know that yet either. And before we go any further, let's just rewrite this equation. Let's solve it for C. So I'm going to bring this C up here, and I'm going to bring these over, alpha and 360, over to the other side. So this is it. This is our answer for the circumference of the Earth. We just need to know alpha and D. So now, let me just talk about this equation a little bit before we move on. First of all, there was nothing wrong with the way we wrote it before. This was a totally true expression that you could use to calculate the circumference. The reason I like this a little better is because, well, it explicitly tells us this is the circumference. And then the way we've written it over here is nice as well. I see I have here 360 over alpha. Now, these are both in degrees. When I do degrees divided by degrees, I get some unitless number. So this is just some multiplier that multiplies a number with unit of distance. So I can see just by looking at this equation that what I will get is a unit of distance, and I can see how it depends on this distance from Alexandria to Siena and the angle of the shadow. I think that's a nice way to show this equation. Now, let's just worry about this angle and the distance and keep track of our units as we do. This may require a new mathematical tool as well. Now, let's go to Florence, Italy to talk to an expert in the field.